Some are called to send. Some are called to go. Don Milam went.
It wasn't my dream for Mozambique. It was God's dream for Mozambique.
But the dream morphed into a hellish reality. Milam, a young man, husband, father of three, missionary, becomes prisoner.
And I'm waiting and I'm thinking a bullet is going to hit me anytime, and I'm thinking I'll never see my kids again. I'll never see my wife again. And I thought that would be the end of my life.
And that would have been easier. Instead, Milam wept and agonized through 300 days that hemorrhaged humiliation, fear, mental torture, firing squads, digging his own grave, and apparent abandonment by his Lord, his Savior.
It's incredible that we understand this story, because it encourages all of us in those moments of our lives when God is asking us for a yes in our spirits, that we really can say yes and make a difference.
Milam's testimony makes the difference.
Somebody like Don can teach people how to live in greater love, how to live in forgiveness, and how to believe God in impossible situations. He's victorious because he came out full of forgiveness and hope for a nation.
And what we have happening right now is that where there was once the world's greatest nightmares, now carries some of the world's greatest stories and greatest breakthroughs.
Don Milam, hero, modern-day martyr.
I would read stories about missionaries and how they suffered, and some missionaries who were martyred. And I would read those stories and think, I could never, ever do that. I couldn't imagine myself.
But one man can, in the name of love, in the name of hope, in the name of forgiveness, in the name of his Lord, his Savior, in the name above all names, Jesus. Now, more than 30 years on this side of freedom and healing and restoration, why would Don Milam feel it necessary, even vital, to return to the land, the very setting of his torturous captivity?
We need to hear this story.